In my view, the next frontier for Muungano in the next 20 years will be one to scale up the achievements in the sense that Muungano has achieved a lot, but that scale has not grown as much. I think we need to be challenged to grow that scope of achievements. Like, if I may just focus directly on my area of competence, which is planning and design of houses, we want to see more of Kambi Motors rolled out at a broader scale and probably as a national agenda for Muungano at that level. So that scaling up is long overdue, and I would expect that would happen in the next 10 years. The next thing would be to probably then also look at how a lot of the issues that Muungano has gone through can also translate into policy matters, so that then we are not just talking about discussions at the movement level. These are discussions that can influence decision at the national level and even for governance. And I would imagine that now with the devolved system of governance, Muungano also needs to retrofit its structure and align itself with that and see how they can now relate to the devolved governance. Because if we're saying that Muungano also agitates for a share of the national cake, they need also to look at where is this cake falling out. And in my view, that is falling out also in the counties. And there would be need to see, like for instance, what's the county budget for infrastructure and how can we tap into it as Muungano? What's the county budget for housing and how can we tap it as into it as Muungano? Because the beauty with the devolved function is that it's a model for participation, and one of the key strengths of Muungano is participation. So if they push for that participation at the county levels, even constitutionally, it's got scope for it. At the national level, they may find a lot of friction to fit in a lot. Well, it will still fit in, but I thought the county government is a good structure for them to move down to. And then, of course, it's good again to reflect on the dynamics of the movement and try to still retain it as a movement. In my view, it's not matured sufficiently to transition from the space of a movement. It would be nice to still have it as a movement. It's a challenge, of course, to keep it as a movement forever. But the strength of Muungano is it's in its movement form. So it would be a challenge also in these coming 20 years to see how that movement works. And again, on this I pass, not probably as a straight challenge to the leadership of Muungano, but would also want to imagine that it's good for Muungano to then have clarity in terms of how it's managed. Even as, if you look at the national structure and all that, how does it cascade to reach out to the people at the bottom? And again, to retain the original vision. I think over time it's very easy to get a lot of benefits on the way and then forget about where we were focused on going. But I think Muungano still has strength to cover the next 20 years in those areas of outlined. I think in terms of scaling up, I've only picked out on scaling up for house construction. There are other matters that need to scale up, mobilization as well. And again, I mentioned about the need to engage with policy matters, because really what will remain forever is the policy matters if they are put down well and they are articulated in different levels of governance. And then I've also talked about how Muungano can sustain itself over time. Because for us to be relevant, for Muungano to be relevant over 20 years, it's got to remain as Muungano. So that would be a big challenge for it.